So this machine behind me is a CNC router. It's a computer-controlled cutter that allows you to cut complex shapes into wood, plastic, or even metal. And what we're going to do today is we're going to cut the coasters that we showed you in our previous videos. We're going to cut them out on this machine. A CNC router uses cutting tools like this. This is called an end mill. It can also use router bits, which you might be familiar with woodworking. Either one will cut through this MDF or other pieces of wood. And we're going to show you how we set it up on this machine. We've already pre-programmed the coasters that we did the other day into the machine. We use what's called G-code to control the machine, and in future videos, we're going to show you how to program the machine in G-code. G-code is a software language that makes this machine understand where it needs to cut the paths that we designed in SOLIDWORKS. It's very simple language. Think of it as Etch-a-Sketch with X, Y, and Z locations that the machine goes to and simply cuts the paths. So what we're going to do now is we're just going to screw down the piece of wood using four holes that we pre-drilled with the software. Let's watch how that works. Let's just hit start. There's the start button. So that's one of our racetracks. That actually happens to be Monaco. You can see it cutting out the path of the Monaco F1 race. And now we just have a waiting period while this machine cuts all the tracks out. Let's take a look at the screen and we can watch all the different commands that it's doing. It's going through them quite quickly, as you can see. The nice thing about this machine is it is self-contained, so the dust doesn't get into the room. And it's pretty easy to clean up. You may want to think about an enclosure for your machine if you decide to build one. It's a really good idea because you can keep it in the house and it really won't cause any problems with dust. And I believe this is our last track. And what it should do next is it'll go around and cut out the actual coasters now that the tracks are done. What we've done is we've designed tabs into each coaster so that they're held in place while it's cutting. If it did pop off, the problem is it would get caught in the cutter and would ruin the coaster. So the way this works is there's a linear bearing. You can see the bar on the side that gives it a real stable platform. And we have servo motors attached to lead screws. Lead screws are just high precision, long bolts basically. They're just a long screw, so you can see it rotating. And attached to that lead screw is a servo motor. And the servo motor is taking the information from our G-code and moving it to the positions that are listed in the G-code. The real innovation here is that this machine is fully automatic. In the old days, they actually had a crank that a person would turn and they'd have to do it manually. But that doesn't allow for really precise moves or complex shapes like this. CNC has really revolutionized the way we make things. The machine basically runs itself and all we have to do is sit here and watch it. You can see we're building up quite a bit of dust now. On the next path, I'm going to install the vacuum and we're going to clean it up. Now, if this machine wasn't self-contained and enclosed like this one, you would have to put a vacuum on it or this sawdust would be all over the room. That's the nice thing about an enclosure. You can run it without having to vacuum it up all the time. It makes it a lot quieter because the vacuum is quite loud. It was a first try and I don't think it came out too bad. We have one last pass to do. We're going to cut out around the edge. This time we've attached the vacuum so that all the dust is collected. You won't be able to see the cutter, but you already know how it works. So I'm aware that this design is really simple, and it's not a product that you would probably sell. But we wanted to start out by showing you how easy it is to get started making things. In future episodes, we're going to build really complex things like furniture, some camera dollies that we need here for our shooting, and some other things. We've Even if you have an idea of something you may want us to make, you let us know in the comments section, and we might design it and build it so you can watch it being done. But think of things that you can design. These are basically 2D objects that can be made into 3D. You can cut the parts here and then put them together. They can be snapped together, nailed together, screwed together, or even glued together if you design it right the way it's cut out here on the wood. So think about the different things that you can do that you can make at home that maybe could be sold online in the future. So you can see that it cut a lot cleaner with the dust collector on. Unfortunately, you weren't able to see the last set of cuts, but it's nice and clean and it looks good. Let's move the head back and take a look. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Invention Therapy. Join us for more episodes in the future where we show you how to make all kinds of things that you can sell online.